Hello guys, thank you so much for supporting this channel and helping me to get motivated to create more videos. I hope you all are all right. Please try to be safe and healthy. I have one good news, that is I made a website. So here is Brownbearanimation and you can check out some blogs. I will be updating twice a month with very helpful tips and tricks. So you better get connected for the updates. You can also access the Brownbear Gumroad page and you can get some free models and some paid models which I will be uploading there. Next, let's move on to the learning stuff. In this video series, we are going to create a game prop. So if you like to get notified when the new video comes, then you know the thing. Hit that subscribe button and turn on the bell icon. Let's move to the video. When you will hide the light box by clicking comma key on the keyboard, you have to go to the simple brush icon and choose the sphere 3D and drag it on the canvas. Then press T for the edit object mode. Then you can change the material. If the pace of the video is slow for you, you can fast forward the video by going on to the YouTube playback speed option. And you can use the S key for the draw size. S key is a shortcut for increasing and decreasing the draw size. Then after that you have to click make polymesh 3D to start sculpting on the mesh. I'm appending a cylinder for the neck of the bottle. You can select the subtool by directly going onto the subtool list, or you can directly click on the subtool by holding alt on the keyboard. Then W for the gizmo. You can place and scale the object according to your needs with the gizmo, and you can keep on appending new subtools for different sections of the bottle. Here in this sculpt also, we have to make sure that we put different primitives for the blocking of the bottle or blocking of the model. Whatever you are modeling, it's always important that you must put basic primitives first to block out the major shapes. Then after that you can keep on refining those shapes by dynamishing them. So in this case I'm just adding different subtools for the different sections of the bottle. I have duplicated the above part. I will provide the reference image in the description box below. You can find the reference image there. You can see that I am continuously appending different cylinders for the different shapes, and this part will be the cap of the bottle, and I am deforming the cap of the bottle with my way of basic steps by masking the cap, then blurring out the mask by control tap on the mesh, then gizmo for scaling in, control tap on the mesh for blurring out the mask. Then for inverting the mask, you have to control click on the empty area of the canvas. I'm repeating those steps again and again for giving it a conical kind of shape. Then I have selected the spherical part and I have applied Dynamesh onto it because I want to sculpt some details onto it. I will extrude a part from the below section of the bottle, and for that I needed a quad, even quad topology. That's why I applied the Dynamesh on the sphere. Then control drag for the mask, and for blurring the mask, control tap on the mesh. I will create the mask. I will keep on adjusting it according to my needs. Then I will extract out a piece of geometry form from that masked area. You can change the smooth slider and thickness slider. This is an option from which you can get a mesh from any masked surface. Whenever you get a desired thickness, after getting desired thickness, you can press the accept button and you will get that extracted part in a different subtool. In this case, I think I will go with 0.09, and then I have clicked on the accept button. Then I will go to radial symmetry, activate symmetry. And there you have to click on the R button and you can change the radial count. In this case, I am taking 6 as a radial count and I am holding control and creating a mask for this kind of design. You can turn on lazy mouse for this thing, but for this step, but I would prefer you to get a good control over your stylus or mouse from which you are going to sculpt the model, because softwares are there to help you, but you have to have a control on your hand. So that you can work without the benefit of the software also. And if the situation calls for, you can go to the stroke menu and you will find lazy mouse option over there. So here I'm creating the mask, and later on I will go and extract out the shape similarly as I have done it earlier. I will extract out shape from this one also. I'm removing the mask by Control and Alt. Control is for creating the mask and Control and Alt for removing the mask. Then again, you can see I have gone to the extract option. Then I will select the desired thickness. And when you select the desired thickness, you will press extract button. Extract button will only give you the preview of the extracted part, but when you click accept button below the extract button, you will get a different subtool for the extracted mesh. I will merge down the neck of the bottle and the sphere of the bottle together. Then I will drag once on the canvas, and Dynamesh will reproject itself again, because I have turned on the Dynamesh on the sphere. That's why whatever sub tool I will merge with the sphere, I have to just drag once on the canvas, then Dynamesh will reproject itself. If you got confused about that step, that how Dynamesh will reproject itself when you just merge two subtools, let me know in the comment section. I will clear it for you. And this part is a triangulated part, basically for the design of the bottle. And in this case, I am using masking for creating this kind of shape, but there are other ways also by which you can create this kind of shape in ZBrush. But I think the tools which I have told you till now, you can easily create this thing by masking trick. Then radial symmetry, and you can easily sculpt this part. I am just smoothing out the mesh very carefully, because if I will smooth the mesh unknowingly, then the crease edge will get disturbed. And I will merge this part with the bottle, and again control drag, and the Dynamesh will do its job. Then I will smooth out the surface by holding shift key, and I will reduce the resolution of the Dynamesh so that I can smooth the mesh more easily. I am using trim dynamic to get a kind of flat shape with the radial symmetry turned on. You can get this kind of interesting shape if you turn on the radial symmetry and just sculpt on the mesh. Then after that, I have increased the resolution, Dynamesh resolution. Radial symmetry is fun to work with. You can create very interesting kind of a mesh with the help of radial symmetry. So I am using trim dynamic for shaping the design part. Then here you can see that I need to edit this part also. I'll scale it a little. Then I'm creating the mask by control drag. Then I will invert the mask, control tap on the empty or in the area of the canvas, then gizmo. With the help of gizmo, I am scaling in that extruded part. Then remove the mask by control drag on the canvas, then apply Dynamesh. So that's enough for the first part of the video. You can share it with your friends and like the video, and also don't forget to subscribe the channel. See you in the next part.